Dear colleagues, good evening. Engine manufacturing, its development, and the state of this industry are undoubtedly one of the key indicators of our technological development and sovereignty. This, I think, is an obvious thing, which is why I asked you to gather today. And I would like to see how the implementation of key programs for the development and production of engines is progressing. As I have already noted, a strategic industry, in essence, with both civilian and defense significance. I am referring to passenger, transport and combat aviation, space exploration, equipment, and power plants for the fuel and energy complex. We will look at what problematic issues exist and what still needs to be done to successfully complete the planned objectives accurately and within the established timelines. Just now, we looked at what has been done at the stands. A great deal has indeed been accomplished, simply impressive. But there are also some issues that require special attention. We need to set benchmarks and specific roadmaps. In principle, they are outlined in strategic planning documents, and I repeat, they require strict compliance. We need to see how they are being implemented. Just now, as I said, we walked through the workshops and familiarized ourselves with the serially produced and prospective samples of products from the United Engine Corporation. I emphasize that both in Soviet times and today, Russia is among the top five global leaders in the development and production of aviation and rocket engines. Over the past 4 years alone, the number of delivered aircraft engines has increased by more than 50%. From 791 to 1,227 units. This year, the import substitution of engines for the ANSAT helicopters in Sukhoi Superjet aircraft has been completed. We just saw all this. It was demonstrated. The latest gas turbine engine, VK650V, and turbojet engine, PD8, which meet the best global standards, have been installed there respectively. Such positive dynamics in the industry create conditions for strengthening the country's industrial and technological sovereignty, for the renewal of transport and energy sectors, and in general for economic growth and the achievement of national development goals. And of course, for the continued steady operation of the industry's enterprises and their numerous partners across the country, throughout the entire cooperation chain. I would like to thank the workforce of the United Engine Corporation, holding for the results achieved and their contribution to strengthening Russia's industrial and defense potential. I emphasize that it is necessary to continue improving modern generation engines, creating groundwork, designing new products, enhancing their reliability and environmental friendliness, applying advanced technologies and innovative solutions, developing the world-renowned domestic design school of aviation and rocket engine manufacturing, and, crucially, creating conditions to attract young talented specialists, entire teams of engineers, developers, and production workers to design bureaus and enterprises. Just now they were telling me, and it was very pleasing to hear, that this very process is taking place. Very good. I would like to draw your special attention to the following. First, I request that you report today on the prospects for using the PD-8 engine beyond the Sukhoi Superjet on other aircraft. Second, it is necessary to promptly complete the development and begin serial production of the PD-26 turbojet engine. This, I remind you, is the first high-thrust aircraft engine developed in Russia. It has fundamentally new capabilities in terms of power and thrust. At the same time, it is efficient and economical. The implementation of this project will allow us to modernize not only military transport aviation, but also open prospects for the construction of a new generation wide-body civilian airliner. And as we know, cooperation is possible here, and our potential partners are also showing great heightened interest in this. I would like to hear how the work on this engine is progressing. Third, Russia was and remains one of the world leaders in the development of cosmonautics, and it is important to consistently update production capacities for the manufacture of engines for launch vehicles. Moreover, we must not only meet our own current and future needs, but also actively enter global markets and successfully compete there. The work in principle is underway, but I would like to hear from you in an official setting. And finally, fourth, under the conditions of sanctions restrictions, we managed to develop a number of innovative engines for the energy sector in a short time. They are actively used, including in gas transportation infrastructure. Given our ambitious plans for the gasification of Russia's regions and new export routes, including the Power of Siberia 2 project, this is an extremely important topic. There are good developments here. Just now, they showed us the serially produced high-power gas turbine engine, GTD110M, which is in no way inferior to and in some parameters surpasses foreign analogs. This engine is in demand and sought after by the domestic fuel and energy complex. It is necessary to increase its production and the volume of deliveries of such products. Let's begin, please.